Pork is a very significant product to many parts of the world, but especially to Scandinavia. In the old days, you know, salt pork was a very large part of the protein intake that people had during the dark winter months. And this dish kind of ties into that because we're using a part of the pig that is quite overlooked in many ways, which is the head. What we do is that we take like the whole head and braise it for a really long time, until the skin and the meat becomes really tender. Then we pick it all off the bone and mix it with picked pieces of meat into sort of a very succulent meat batter. So this is Michael, who is responsible for this dish during service and also during the prep in the restaurant. And we're going to make it as if it was service, basically. So we're gonna start with deep frying them.
So after I've dredged the pig head in corn flour, I want to tap it a little bit on the dish so that there's no excess starch on the outside while I batter it. When I go into the batter, I'm going to give it a little stir because I don't want any bubbles on the pig's head. And then I kind of give it a little roll like that before coming back down and dipping it straight into the oil.
It's very important to coat the stick like Michael did here, because when you fry this very sort of succulent meat batter in there, it melts and becomes almost liquid. And if you don't have that piece of batter going up on the stem of the stick, it will just sort of wobble off the stick when you pick it up. So it has to be, it's like a handle.
I'm gonna keep that down in the oil until it's got a nice golden brown color. And then usually I can do more than one at a time, so I'll do another one.
And then during service, we do 16 of these at a time. And you will like hold them between all your fingers and dunk them down into the deep fryer.
It's not easy.
So these are pickled gooseberries. We take them when they're unripe, when they're green, and we just dry salt them and put them in jars and leave them to ferment in the cellar, in the root cellar. And this produces something that tastes like a pickled unripe plum, almost. Very kind of savory, but also like acidic and fruity at the same time. So I'm just gonna cut two thin slices of that and place one on each piece of pig's head. Like that. So I'll place the first pig's head here, in this box of hot stones. How are you doing on the second one?
I'm about there, actually.
Into the box. Season with that. And then I have this very fragrant spruce salt. Kind of smells like forest, you know, like walking in the forest. And it's good to have this. It brightens up the whole dish.